Good evening. Welcome to the daily live stream. I'm here every night at 10 p.m. sharing my love for music with you, playing piano for you, eventually fulfilling your request. If you have any requests, let me know. I'm preparing songs. I have quite a list of things I've been asked to play and prepare. I'm working on it. Please give me time, but there is time because our government here in the Netherlands, in Holland, they announced that this is still going to take a long time, this lockdown thing, and which is very unfortunate, to say the least. But, you know, staying positive is very important. We artists, we all are suffering a lot from all these dozens of concerts being cancelled. But as long as we're healthy and take care of others, stay positive. What else can we do? And in the meanwhile, I'll be streaming live as much. Well, actually, every day. I don't intend to stop this for the time being. And on Monday, there is a piano class. So if you like this live stream and you're on Facebook, I would really appreciate if you share it. You just share it from your profile. You can also do via video party or simply share. And on my YouTube channel, there is a lot to be seen, many videos, a lot of collaborations with world music. So please go to my YouTube channel and subscribe. And of course, you can also listen to most of my albums actually on Spotify. So please do if you feel like. For those of you on Instagram, ciao Luca, good to see you. Looking forward to your live stream on Friday. Luca Charla, wonderful violin player from Italy. We were supposed to start a duo actually this week. I was supposed to travel to South Africa tomorrow and for a big tour also with Luca playing concerts. But of course, this has all been, let's not say canceled, it has been it will be postponed. So, more about this duo we're going to seriously work on this. So, let me check the chats here. My cousin Ben is here. Ben, he's a captain with KLM and actually a very good bass player. So is his father. And thanks for tuning in, Ben. Like I've said, I talked before about Ben weeks ago. He's my cousin, and already as a kid, he was like on these old Commodore computers. He was always totally obsessed with flight simulators and all of that. And now he flies planes worth of millions of dollars all over the world. KLM flying thousands of people over the oceans. At least, of course, I mean, not for the time being, but this will also at some point will start again. And thanks for the compliment. Yeah, about my new setup. Yeah, because I wanted to use two keyboards, also this one, you know, and I've changed a little bit the setup, but also I enhanced the sound. I'm always working on the sound. You know, I love when people live stream, it's great. But sometimes what sometimes bothers me a little bit, if you just hear the microphone from the phone or the iPad or whatever, or the computer, and you know, it doesn't sound too good. And with a couple of simple adjustments, you can make the sound, I think, much better. I don't say my sound is perfect, but at least I'm working on it with putting some reasonable mics in the piano and all of that. And this speaking mic, which will hopefully, transmit my voice in the right way. But actually, if there is a problem, a technical problem, let me know, because despite all the testing, you never know how it comes across on the internet. So again, send me a request. Hi Bert, hi Masha, wonderful singer from the Netherlands. We did a tour in Sweden many years ago. We played all over Sweden with the great Tony Lakatos on saxophone, and that was a lot of fun. So today, what I wanted to share with you in terms of listening to other music was that's something really I really want to do more. Well, I've started this last week, and I found a way to play YouTube videos, or at least sound, through this software. The problem is a little bit that I think it's the internet speed or whatever, to stream and to play a YouTube video, it kind of starts, you know, the YouTube video starts slowing down and it's a little bit messed up. But then I found a way to just play you the audio, explaining a little bit and etc. So I can show you YouTube, or at least play a track through this software. And I don't want to play a jazz or a Brazilian tune tonight. Another big musical love I have, and which music I admire so much, is flamenco. And I've done some flamenco projects in the past, but this is like, you know, it's like Indian music, or you know, this is so sophisticated music, so difficult to master, and it's also something you should leave to the masters. But of course, by, you know, explaining all these rhythms and the buleria and all of that, and cigarilla and tango, tanguillos, I really learned a lot from this music. But I simply love it, and I still, of course, we had Paco de Lucia, who died a couple of years ago. I'm going to play something from him, but he collaborated with the Ella Fitzgerald, the of the flamenco, in this case a man, Camarón de la Isla, and Camarón, all the flamenco musicians have nicknames, and Camarón means shrimp, and he was from Cádiz. Cádiz is like in the Andalusia in Spain. Actually, it's a kind of an island, so his name was the Shrimp of the Island. And this man, especially after he met Paco de Lucia and they start collaborating, he became like, the most iconic flamenco singer ever. Of course, there are a lot of people now, but he was so iconic. And there was this beautiful album which he recorded with the symphony orchestra, and it's called Soy Gitano. Soy Gitano means I'm a gypsy. So I'm going to switch on the browser here. Flamenco is like jazz or classical, you know, it's an incredible art. We're getting there. So please listen to Camarón with this beautiful symphony orchestra. And now the question is, why can't I scroll? This is strange. Just a second, sorry about this. I'm not 100% sure now if this is going to be the... Just a second, please. Yeah. This is a bit. So, right there. And then it should be. All right, I'm going to play you this track. No, I think it's here. I'm sorry. So, just enjoy Camarón de la Isla. said that. Okay, here we go. Okay, here you go. Sorry about that. Yeah, the incredible Camarón de la Isla, iconic flamenco singer. He already died many years ago, but it's beautiful. Actually, on Netflix, there is a beautiful documentary about his life with beautiful old footage from all these small, like, tavernas, you know, these flamenco joints in Andalusia. It's beautiful. It's actually on Netflix. Search for Camarón on Netflix, and it's really beautiful, very beautiful. And also, of course, the master Paco de Lucía is a lot there too. So actually, there are a couple of great things. So there is the Quincy Jones documentary, John Coltrane, Chasing Train, very impressive. And there's also one, I still have to check that one out, about Lee Morgan, the jazz trumpet player. So there's some, actually there are some great documentaries on Netflix about Nina Simone, well, Whitney Houston, more pop, but there's a lot there. So, yeah. Hi, Patrick. Thanks for being here. I'll contact you tomorrow about this promotion thing. Hey, John, thanks for being here as well. Hubert John is asking me, how can you enlighten us a bit now how you practice and learn the world of flamenco? Ooh. Well, you know, let me make this very clear. I'm absolutely not a flamenco a pianist by far. What I did, I'm totally fascinated by 6/8, 12/8, 3/4 rhythms. And what I really like rhythms, I really like to play like this one. Like, so you count four, one, and then one, two. So you count four with your foot. One, I don't know if you can hear it. And then one, two, three, one, two, three, four, five, six, one, two, three, four. This actually originates from Africa, of course. And it spread all over the world, and it found this, worked its way into, of course, Cuban music, Brazilian music, Peruvian music, flamenco. And this is like a nice piano pattern, I think. Like, so you hear that one. So one, two, three, four, five, six. One, two, three, four, five, six. Under a four. So that's four is always the thing you keep feeling. And that's interesting. I mean, there are variations on this 12/8 thing. In flamenco, they and all of that, and they put the beats in different places, the accents, like in the buleria. But it's that feeling of four, 6/4, with that four thing, which is always there. If you see these women in Africa dancing to these rhythms, they always had this. So. Yeah, and what's interesting with the flamenco is what I know about it. Don't get me wrong, because I absolutely hate to sound like a flamenco specialist here, which I'm not. But I know that they think like in 12, to down, so they have 12 beats. And then they put the accents in the buleria. And that's their kind of clave. Like you have a clave kind of, or you know, most of these rhythms have certain accents, whether you talk about baião in Brazilian music, like or in bossa nova, so all these rhythms have kind of a clave specific accents, and with the flamenco it's very sophisticated, and it goes over cycle of 12. It's music, it's beautiful, it's really something to explore. And now I'm only talking about a couple of musical styles. This rhythm thing is totally amazing. Hi, Gregory from Cape Town. How are you? Yes, there are two Camarón files. Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I think it's like a series. It's beautiful, this Cameron stuff. Yeah, check that out. All right, I'm gonna turn back to the piano, play something for you. Switch off the mic, otherwise too much echo. This was I Fall in Love Too Easily. Lovely standard. I was just invited by a private Zoom meeting by Adrian Meurs, wonderful Australian trombone player and a very good pianist, very musical, beautiful musician. And he does like Zoom meetings, but only private with a couple of people, which is also nice. Of course, it's nice to stream for people, but with the Zoom seeing each other in an intimate setting also, it certainly has it's a beautiful thing. And he played this song before, and I thought, well, let me do the same thing. I Fall in Love Too Easily. Let me check. All right, so I'm gonna play one more for you. And this is again with this backing track YouTube channel. Again, I've said it before, this backing tracks is a really nice YouTube channel with a lot of standards, bossas, there's a lot of music there. And of course, nothing comes close to play with your own people, but given the fact that we're going to be in this situation for a long time still, at least here, but I think in other countries as well, of course, the whole world is affected by this. It is a very good alternative to practice and to play along with a really good rhythm section. I'm really surprised by the quality. And also it has, backing tracks has for pianist, there are many tracks without piano, only bass and drums. But that really comes in handy. So I'm gonna play a song by Dizzy Gillespie. Thank you. This was Woody and You by actually Dizzy Gillespie. He wrote some great songs. Another one I really love is Con Alma. I'll play that also for you in the near future. I'm going to close for today. Again, if you like this live stream, please share. I would really appreciate it. On Facebook, it's on YouTube as well. Subscribe to my channel. I'm here every night at 10. Send me your request, and I hope to see you tomorrow. And thanks for watching. Thanks for listening, and stay safe and stay healthy. And please take care of other people as well. All my love. Thank you. Hopefully see you tomorrow. Good night.